Hello, welcome to my channel, Jackie's Arts. Today, I'm starting with a black canvas. What I'm gonna do, I have no idea. It looks like I'm gonna do a paint pour. These are my colors. We got red, yeehaw, purple, woohoo, brown, orange, something, and then blue. So, I already mixed my paints. They're all right here. We're going to put them all in one cup because we're going to do the one cup method. On the blue, I actually did something different because I didn't want to add any more black. So I made like a, I used a lot of blue with some black. So we'll see how that looks with it. I thought it'd give it a little different texture. All right. So here we go. Now we're going to sit here and we're going to make one cup. So the colors that I really want on top are the vibrant colors. So I'm going to put a little bit of white first in my cup. Because remember, the ones you pour in first are going to be the ones that end up on top. I'm going to go with a little bit of this color. I'm going to go with a little bit of my mixed color. It's like a grayish blue. Do a bit on that. Then I'm gonna do some purple. I'm spiraling it around because when it comes out, I want it to be spiral. And then a little blue. Then a little bit of red here. Gently. Okay. Then I'm going to go with a little bit of white. Okay. I'm going to go back with this mixed bluish gray. I'm actually going to put that right in the middle. And then I'm going to start building my colors on top of that one. A little bit of red. Now, before I put blue back in there, I'm actually going to separate it with some white again. I want a little white separated between this next layer of blue. Okay. Then we're going to go with some of my brownish orange. Please excuse me. I was messing at the stables all day. Kind of have alfalfa algae. Doesn't hit me all the time, but when you're cleaning up and getting a whole bunch of hay delivered, yeah, it hits me pretty good. Okay, so let's do a purple. Get some nice blue on top of that purple. Okay, and then we'll put some red on top of that. And then, as I get messy, I'm going to put some white, just a little bit. I don't want that much white on the top. Back to my blue-gray. And then I'm going to finish it up with my brown-orange. Alright, put my other cups aside. Each one of my cups still have a little bit of paint, just in case this isn't enough and I need to be able to spread it a little bit more. Or I might use all my leftover paints and make a little one. So first I want to get this up off of here. Actually, let me pause because my allergy is killing me a little bit. Hold on for one moment. Okay, I'm back. So now, I'm not exactly sure where I want to start this. So Actually, I do know. I'm going to do right in the middle. I'm going to shake it. Oh yeah, here comes the purples. Ended up nice. I'm gonna fill up the middle with, because purples are coming out and that's what I wanted. There we go. Go back on the edge. Okay, here we go. All right. So now, we're going to start moving. Here we go. See what happens. Oh yeah, I can already tell. It's getting some nice movement in here. Stretch it back this way. I want to stretch that color in the very back right here. I want to stretch that out a little bit. So I'm going to bring it back down this way. I want to get these colors moving pretty good. I already got this one coming off the edge, so I'm just gonna take some of this, just put it up here. All that does right there, it doesn't ruin it, it just helps everything start sliding down better. Once it hits that side, it's gonna start coming down a lot easier. Let it fall off, here we go. Now we're gonna come down the sides. Just hoping it comes down here some. I don't know if you can see that very well. I think I may have put my hand in the way. But see how I got the edge right here? It just helps it come down. I want it to flow off the edge right there. There we go. Pick it up, get it, start moving it down this way. And you can see it start to stretch right there. All this is gonna do is help it move down some. I'm not messing with any of the colors, I'm just moving it down. There we go. So see what it does when you do that, it just helps it to move down along the edge. Helps it smooth, come down. And once it hits that wet spot that I just did, that muddy color, it'll come down a lot easier. Actually, I think this is one of the best ones I've done. The colors are stretching nicely how I want them. You know, sometimes it takes a little bit of time. Like I said, you can help it along a little bit. It just helps it to stretch a little bit more. There we go. Now it's starting to come down better. Go. Yeah, just need to hit that bottom right there. Don't be afraid of ever having too much paint, because having too little makes it take a long time to come down to the bottom. It doesn't mess it up because my painting's not messed up. It just, you know, takes a little bit of time, which is fine. I don't mind. It's not like I'm in a hurry. Before I run out, I'm actually going to start moving this over here. Try to get to come down this way a little bit more. And if you do get to a spot where you don't have enough paint, you just add a little more. And it doesn't mess it up at all. All it'll do is help the other paint squish back down. So you pick it up and you'll see. Mix it back up with the other ones. Be careful, because I almost decided that I wanted to paint my shirt. Okay. And then bring it back down. There we go. Bring it down this way. Okay. And you'll see that everything is starting to blend together. When it blends completely together, I'll call it quits. So give me 1 second. Right here, it needs a little bit of work. Here we go. Here we go. Just a tab right there, because there's still an open spot right there. Right there. And that's it. So once that moves down, all right, got a spot over here that decided to be paint. This is why you always keep extra paint. Extra paint, when you're doing a paint pour, is good. Rubber gloves when you're doing a paint pour is even better. All right, make sure it comes down the sides, and it did, and there you go. There's our paint pour. I would be happy to say hi, but it's kind of way up there, so I'm just going to go ahead and pause the video. Okay, bye-bye. Have a great day. Remember, if you like this, please subscribe. I hope you have a great day. Bye.